That's it. Lذلك a story that Ibn al-Jawzi mentioned it, just to show you, and this is something that you really should share with your children. Al-Hasan al-Basri is the one who came up with the story, and he said, in a town, there used to be Muslims. By all of a sudden, the people started worshipping a tree, thinking that tree is holy, and they used to go around the tree, actually offer qurbani to the tree, praying to the tree. A righteous man in town, enjoying good and forbid evil. My countrymen are worshipping a tree, I gotta do something. He said, at night while they are asleep, I'll take my axe and go and take the tree down. End of story. So he took his axe, he's going. Guess who meets him on the way? Shaitan, taking a human form. Where are you going? He said, I'm going to cut that tree. He said, no, you're not going. He said, yes, I am. He said, no, you're not. He said, yes, I am. They got in a fight. They boxed. The man beating up Shaitan so bad. Beating him up. Of course, when Shaitan gets defeated this way, he normally comes to you, sweetens up things about how to get to you. And the brothers, if Shaitan doesn't get to you, the scholars, they say, he will send a sister to you, a woman. When he fails to get to you, normally the women will deliver. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ما تركت فتنة أشد على الرجال من النساء. He said to him, listen, you know you're a righteous guy. Here you are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These guys went astray already. They already worship that tree. Just forget about them, man. I'll give you 3 dinar every day. You get to stay at home. You worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 24/7. You're good to go. Just don't worry about those people. Man, this is a good idea. 3 dinars a day, $3, that will provide for me. So he went home. The first night, the three dinars were delivered. The second day, the 3 dinars were delivered. The third day, no more. He said, you know what? I gotta go and cut that tree now. So he takes the axe. He's going to cut the tree. Shaitan met him again. Where are you going, my friend? I'm going to cut the tree. He said, no, you're not. He said, yes, I am. He said, no, you're not. He said, yes, I am. They got in a fight. This time, Shaitan beating him so bad. He's sitting and wondering, why in the world did I defeat you the first time? And why you got me the second time? Remember that statement, brothers and sisters in Islam. The first time you were doing this for Allah. The second time you were doing it for the money. Remember, if you want to defeat Shaitan, check that intention. Make sure that you're doing what you're doing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second thing, brothers and sisters in Islam, to protect yourselves from Shaitan is seeking the means. You know, we do have a very famous booklet that is in every home almost. I enjoy and admire the author for giving it this name. The book I'm referring to, or the booklet I'm referring to, called Hisnul Muslim, The Fortress of the Muslim. You know why he called that? You know why he called that booklet this way? There is a beautiful hadith, Hadith al-Harith al-Ash'ari, radiallahu anhu. Hadith in Sunan Ibn Majah and others, and Nasa'i, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Yahya to act upon certain commands. It's a lengthy hadith, but one of the commands, he said, وَأُوصِيكُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَآمُرُكُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ I command you to always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنَّمَا مَثَلُ ذَلِكَ The likeness of this, that someone is running and an enemy behind him. الشيطان is like, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, الشيطان ذئب الإنسان. Shaitan is the wolf of man. He's behind you, tracing you. Now, when you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as if you have entered into a fortress. فَإِذَا ذَكَرَ اللَّهِ دَخَلَ حِصْنًا حَصِينًا الأذكار. We're so negligent of الأذكار الموظفة. In the morning when we wake up, at night, when we enter the house, there is a jinni standing next to you. Imagine, when you enter your home, there is a jinni standing next to you. When you say Bismillah, he doesn't enter. When you start eating, you say Bismillah, he doesn't eat. When you drink, you say Bismillah, he doesn't drink with you, using the right hand. When you go to sleep at night, if you recite Ayat al-Kursi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send an angel and the jinni will be kicked away. When you enter the bathroom, when you make the dua, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubth wal-khaba'ith, he doesn't harm you inside the room. When you recite the Quran and you want to understand the Quran, you're supposed to say a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Imagine that personal relationship, intimacy, a relationship between a husband and a wife. You're supposed to mention Allah His name before you actually do it. Subhanallah, shaitan doesn't harm you nor harm the offspring. Brothers and sisters in Islam, al-dhikr, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially al-adhkar al-muwadhafa, adhkar al-sabah, adhkar al-masa. It takes some time to get used to it, but do it. It will make a whole big difference in your lives. I'll never forget this sheikh. He taught me something so beautiful. We were riding on a bus together with another group of mashayikh going somewhere. And by all of a sudden, before the sun set, he got engaged in adhkar al-masa, reciting them with a low tone. So I had the urge of talking to him. I wasn't considered that he's doing his adhkar. So he kept interrupting me. I kept interrupting him. So he said, you know, son, I don't have insurance. I don't have health insurance. And this is my health insurance. I gotta pay for it. My adhkar. Brothers and sisters in Islam, enter into that fortress. Finally, there is nothing better that can protect you from Satan than knowledge. Knowledge. The knowledge of the deen. The scholars, they say, عَالِمٌ وَاحِدٌ أَشَدُّ عَلَى الشَّيْطَانِ مِنْ أَلْفِ عَابِدٍ. A scholar is harder on shaitan than 1,000 worshippers without knowledge. Acquire the knowledge of Islam. In closing, brothers and sisters in Islam, again, I echo, this life is a test. This life is a trial. And sometimes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tries us with enemies from the human and enemies from the jinn that we cannot fight. We can't. The only solution, us turning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, help me, Ya Rabb. Help me, Ya Rabb, against Shaitan, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Help me against that person. And when you turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is what Allah wants. And sometimes it's actually good to be inflicted if you are not turning to Allah willingly. Some of us need to be beaten a little bit, inflected a little bit, in order to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I know some of you are wondering, why did Allah create Satan? For that wisdom. To test you. So that you turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from Satan and from his works. I always wanted to close with this verse that I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never to hear it from the mouth of Satan. Satan actually will have a final sermon in hell, and he will be addressing those whom he succeeded to make them companions of the blazing fire. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recorded that sermon in a beautiful chapter in Surah Ibrahim. I mean it this time. I'm going to recite the verses, tell you the meanings in English. And this is the sermon of Satan addressing his followers. Here is what he will say. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وقال الشيطان لما قضي الأمر إن الله وعدكم وعد الحق ووعدتكم فأخلفتكم وما كان لي عليكم من سلطان إلا أن دعوتكم فاستجبتم لي فلا تلوموني ولوموا أنفسكم ما أنا بمصرخكم وما أنتم بمصرخي إني كفرت بما أشركتمون من قبل إن الظالمين لهم عذاب أليم. When the people of Jannah are in Jannah and the people of hell are in hell, Satan will stand and address those who are in hell with them, with him. وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانُ لَمَّا قُضِيَ الْأَمْرِ. Allah has promised you a promise of truth. The promise of Allah was true. And I promised you, but I broke my promise. Ha 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 ha. But I didn't beat you up. وَمَا كَانَ لِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانِ. I didn't hit you. I didn't force you to do. No, I whispered to you. إِلَّا أَنْ دَعَوْتُكُمْ. And you responded to me. Blame me not. Blame yourselves. And if we do blame one another, this is not going to help us. It's over. I disbelieved already a long time ago. Indeed, the dwellers, the oppressors or the transgressors will be the dwellers of hell for eternity. Brothers and sisters in Islam, أقول قولي